ओके स्टूडेंट्स, क्लास 11th मैथमेटिक्स सीबीएसई। टुडे वी आर सॉल्विंग द एग्जांपल्स एंड क्वेश्चंस ऑफ द एक्सरसाइज 5.1। ओके, कॉम्प्लेक्स नंबर्स। इन दीज एग्जांपल्स एंड क्वेश्चंस वी विल हैव द पावर्स ऑफ आइटा, कॉम्प्लेक्स नंबर्स, इक्विटी ऑफ कॉम्प्लेक्स नंबर्स, एडिशन, मल्टीप्लीकेशन, डिविजन एंड सब्ट्रैक्शन ऑफ द कॉम्प्लेक्स नंबर्स एंड प्रॉपर्टी ऑफ द ऑपरेशंस ऑन कॉम्प्लेक्स नंबर्स। ओके, सो वी विल सॉल्व द क्वेश्चंस ऑफ ऑल दीज टाइप्स। ओके, सो दिस इज द फर्स्ट एग्जांपल। दिस इज द फर्स्ट एग्जांपल इन विच टू कॉम्प्लेक्स नंबर्स आर गिवन इक्वल। टू कॉम्प्लेक्स नंबर्स आर गिवन इक्वल एंड वी हैव टू फाइंड द वैल्यूज ऑफ एक्स एंड वाई। वी हैव टू फाइंड द वैल्यूज ऑफ एक्स एंड वाई। Two complex numbers are equal. We have already told you two complex numbers are equal if their corresponding parts are equal. Means real part of first complex number equal to real part of the second complex number and imaginary part of the first complex number is equal to the imaginary part of the second complex number. Okay. After that we will solve the given equations and will find the values of x and y. Here the real part of first complex number is 4x. Okay, and real part of second complex number is 3. So 4x equals to 3 means x equals to 3/4. And imaginary part of the first complex number 3x minus y is equals to the imaginary part of the second complex number, that is minus 6. So 3x minus y equals to minus 6. Here y is equal to 3x plus 6 and 3 into x, x that is 3/4 plus 6. So 9 plus 24/4 that is 33/4. Okay. So y is equal to 33/4. In this way, we can find the values of x and y. The main thing here is the equality of the two complex numbers. Okay. So now let us take the Example number second
of the same exercise, that is 5.1.
So example number second example is page number 101. Okay, express the following in the form of standard complex number. Express the following. Two, three parts are given and you have to express these parts in the standard form of the complex number. So I will taking the second part
of the second example, and it is minus iota multiplied with 2 iota multiplied with minus 1 upon 8 into iota. All the iotas are in numerator.
So we have to find the, or we have to solve this and find, we have to solve this and put this in standard form of the complex number. Standard form of the complex number is a plus iota b. A plus iota b means real part of z plus imaginary part of z.
Okay, so this is equals to minus 1 multiplied by 2 multiplied by minus 1 upon 8, constant will multiply constant, and iota, imaginary unit.
Iota is the imaginary unit. Imaginary unit will multiplied with imaginary unit.
So iota to the power 3. Iota to the power 3. So minus minus plus 2 4 to 8, 1 upon 4 into iota cube. And iota cube is equal to minus iota. So minus 1 upon 4 iota.
Minus 1 upon 4 iota. This is the simplest form of the given number. So here we have only the imaginary part, not real part.
So this can be put in the 0 plus minus 1 upon 4 iota. Okay. In a plus iota b means, when we compare this with a plus iota b, a equals to 0 and b equals to minus 4. Okay, so this is the standard form of the given
given complex number. Okay, this was example number second. First part you can do on the same lines. Now the example number three. Example number three is 5 minus 3 iota to the power 3. 5 minus 3 iota to the power 3. Put this in standard form. Put the given complex number in the standard form of the complex number. 5 minus 3 iota to the power 3. We have to put this in standard form, that is a plus iota b. Okay. So a minus b whole cube. We will use here the identity for a minus b whole cube. And this is equals to, we know that a cube minus 3a square b plus 3ab square minus b cube. Okay, this is the identity. Here a equals to 5 and b equals to 3. Okay, 3 iota. So 5 minus 3 iota cube is equals to 5 cube minus 3 into a square, 5 square into 3 iota square. 3 iota, sorry, only 3 iota, and then plus 3 into 5 into 3 iota square, and lastly minus b cube minus 3 iota whole cube. Okay, now solving this, 135 iota plus 3 3 9 3 27 into 4 133 to 27 into 135 iota square minus 3 3 9 3 27 iota cube. So this is equals to 125 minus 135 iota minus 135 plus minus 27 into iota cube minus iota. So finally this is equals to 125 minus 135. This is real part, and minus 135 iota plus 27 iota. So equals to minus 10 minus 108 iota. Okay, so this is the standard form of the given complex number 5 minus 3 iota to the power whole cube. Okay, now the next example number 4. Let us have the example number 4. Example number 4 is, now we have to multiply this minus under root 3 will multiply 2 under root 3 minus iota plus iota under root 2 will multiply 2 under root 3 minus iota. So this is equals to minus under root 3 into 2 under root 3, 2 under root 3 minus minus plus under root 3 iota plus iota 2 into under root 3 into under root 2 minus iota square under root 2. So this is equals to minus 2 into 3 minus 6 minus 6 plus under root 3 iota plus 2 3 ja, sorry, 2 under root 6 iota minus plus under root 2. So equals to minus 6 plus under root 2 and iota is taken as common under root 3 plus 2 under root 6. Okay. So this is the standard form. This is the standard form means this is A plus iota B. This can be written as A plus iota B. Here A equals to minus 6 plus under root 2 and B is equals to under root 3 plus 2 under root 6. Okay. So in this way we can put the given complex number in standard form after multiplying the terms, after multiplying the brackets. Okay. Now let us take the next question, question number 5. Question number 5, this can also be put in the form of, this can also be put in the form of minus 6 plus under root 2 plus iota under root 3 plus 2 into under root 3 into under root 2. So minus 6 plus under root 2 plus iota under root 3 is taken as common 1 plus 2 under root 2. Okay, both are same. Now taking the example number 5. We are solving the examples of the exercise of 5.1. Example number 5. Example number 5 is Example number 5 is 5 the multiplicative inverse of 2 minus 3 iota. 2 minus 3 iota multiplicative inverse. Okay. So the given complex number is 2 minus 3 iota and we have to find the multiplicative inverse. Multiplicative inverse of the complex number z is 1 upon z. Multiplicative inverse of the complex number z is equals to 1 upon z. So 1 upon 2 minus 3 iota. This is the multiplicative inverse. But we have to put this in standard form A plus iota B. That is why we will multiply this by the complex conjugate. And complex conjugate of this is 2 plus 3 iota divided by 2 plus 3 iota. After multiplying we will have 2 plus 3 iota divided by 2 to the 4 plus 3 to the 9 and this is equals to 2 plus 3 iota upon 13. So multiplicative inverse equals to 2 upon 13 plus 3 upon plus iota 3 upon 13. This is the multiplicative inverse of the given complex number. Okay, in this way we can find the multiplicative inverse. In this way, we can find the multiplicative inverse. This was question number 5. This was question number 5. Now, the next question, question number 6. Question number 6, this we have again expressed in A plus iota B means standard form of the complex numbers. Okay, standard form of the complex numbers A plus iota B. Standard form of the complex number is the A plus iota B. Okay. So question number 6. Express the following in the form of first part. The given complex number is 5 plus under root 2 into iota upon 5 1 minus under root 2 into iota. We have to put this in a plus iota b in the standard form. Okay, here again we have to multiply this by its complex conjugate
of the denominator, that is 1 plus under root 2 into iota upon 1 plus under root 2 into iota. So after multiplying we will have 5. This will multiply this 5 into 1 plus 5 under root 2 iota plus under root 2 into 1 into iota plus under root 2 into under root 2 into iota, that is iota square. Okay, after multiplying we will have this, and here we are having 1 plus under root 2 square. We know that a plus iota b multiplied by a minus iota b is equals to a square plus b square. Okay,
a plus iota b multiplying a minus iota b is equals to a square plus b square.
Okay, so now this is equals to 5 plus 5 under root 2 iota plus under root 2 iota plus 2 iota square, that is 2 into minus 1. So 5 minus 2 plus 6 plus divided by 1 plus 2, that is 3. So 5 minus 2 is the real part, plus 5 under root 2 plus under root 2, 6 under root 2 iota is the imaginary part divided by 4. So 3 plus 6 under root 2 iota upon 4. So equals to 3 upon 4 plus 3 upon 4 plus 6 upon 4, that is 3 upon 2 under root 2 into iota. Okay, this is the standard form of the given complex number. This can again be put in the form of 3 upon 4 plus 3 upon under root 2 iota. Okay, so this was example number 6, first part of the example number 6. Now the next part, we will take next part also. So next part is iota to the power minus 35. Iota to the power minus 35, and we want to put this in standard form of the complex number. Standard form of the complex numbers. So example number 6th, second part, and second part is iota to the power minus 35. Iota to the power minus 35, we want to solve this and want to put in the form of a plus iota b. Okay, so 1 upon iota to the power 35. 1 upon iota to the power 35, positive, this is negative, then power is positive in denominator. So this can again be written down as 4 into 8 plus 3, that is 1 upon iota to the power 4 to the power 8 into 1 upon iota to the power 3. This one is 1, so 1 upon 1 is 1, so equals to 1 upon iota to the power 3.
1 upon iota to the power 3. Now multiplying this again by iota into iota means iota upon iota to the power 4, and iota to the power 4 is again 1. Iota to the power 4 is again 1.
So iota upon 1 equals to iota. Okay, so iota to the power minus 35 is equals to iota.
That is purely imaginary complex number. Okay, no real part is there, that is why purely imaginary complex number.
So this can be written as 0 plus 1 iota. Okay, in the standard form, that is a plus iota b, a equals to 0 and b equals to 1. Okay,
so all these are the example of exercise 5.1. Now we will take the exercise 5.1. We will take some of the questions of the exercise 5.1. Okay,
so let us run this and
the questions of the exercise 5.1. So first of all, let us take the question number second. Directly we will solve the question number second. And question number second is given as iota to the power 9 plus iota to the power 19. Iota to the power 9 plus iota to the power 19. Here the main thing is to discuss or to know the integral power of the iota. Positive integral power, negative integral power of the iota. And we have already told you iota equals to iota. Iota square equals to minus 1, iota to the power 3 equals to minus iota, and iota to the power 4 equals to plus 1. And iota to the power n equals to iota to the power 4n plus r, that is iota to the power r, where n is greater than 4. And n can be put in the form of 4n plus r. So iota to the power n equals to iota to the power r. This we have already discussed. So no long discussion is here on this topic. We will solve the questions directly. So come to this question. Iota to the power 9 plus iota to the power 19, and this can be write down as 4 into 2 plus 1 plus iota to the power 4 into 4 plus 3. So iota to the power 4 whole square into iota to the power 1 plus iota to the power 4 into 4 plus, sorry, multiplying iota to the power 3. This is one. So iota plus, so equals to iota plus iota to the power 3. And iota to the power 3 is equals to minus iota. We know that iota to the power 3 is equals to minus iota, just we have write down here. So iota plus minus iota is equals to 0. Means 0 plus iota, 0. Okay. So the standard form of this complex number is. So the standard form of this complex number is 0 plus iota, 0. 0 complex number. 0 complex number. This is question number second. Now we will take the next question. That is question number 7. Directly come to the question number 7. Okay. All other questions you can do easily. Question number 7 is bracket 1 by 3 plus iota 7 by 3. Okay. Plus second complex number is 4 plus iota 1 upon 3. 4 plus iota 1 upon 3, all are positive till now. Plus minus 4 by 3 plus iota. Okay, so this is a complex number. Addition of two complex number, difference of third complex number. Now we want to put this in standard form, a plus iota b, and we'll find the value of a and b. What are the values of a and b? Okay, so easily we can put, as we have already done so many examples and questions also. So put the, first of all write down this like this: 1 upon 3 plus iota 7 by 3 plus 4 plus iota 1 upon 3 and minus plus 4 upon 3 minus iota. Okay, we have extend all the brackets, remove all the brackets. Okay, now add the real numbers, add all real numbers in one bracket and all imaginary numbers in other bracket. Okay, so real numbers are 1 upon 3 plus 4 plus 4 by 3. These are the real parts, and imaginary parts are 7 by 3 plus 1 by 3 minus 1 iota. Okay, iota is also taking as common. So solve these, taking 3 as LCM, 1 plus 12 plus 4, and taking 3 as LCM, 7 plus 1 minus 3 iota. So very easy. 12 plus 4, 16 plus 1, 17, 17 upon 3 plus 7 plus 1, 10 minus 3, 7 plus 1, 8 minus 3, 5, 5 by 3 iota. Okay, so this is the standard form of complex number a plus iota b. Here a is equals to 17 by 3 and b is equals to 5 by 3. Okay, a equals to b equals to. So in this way we can put the given complex number in simple complex number, complex number into simple complex number by solving like this. Okay, we will add, we know that we have already learned the property of addition and subtraction of two complex numbers. Real part is added in real part is subtracted from real part. Okay, imaginary part is added in imaginary part and imaginary part is subtracted from imaginary part. That is why we will add and subtract real part togetherly and imaginary part togetherly. Okay, in different brackets. After that solving and get the answer. Okay, now next question is question number, taking the question number 10. Okay, so question number 10 is, question number 10 is minus 2 minus 1 upon 3 minus 2 minus 1 upon 3 iota to the power 3. Okay, so we have to solve this. Now taking minus 2 outside the bracket, so minus 2 plus 1 upon 3 iota to the power 3. Now no problem should be there, both the terms are positive and we will use a plus b whole cube. A plus B whole cube. Okay, so minus A plus B whole cube means A cube plus 3 into A square B 1 upon 3 iota plus 3AB square 1 upon 3 iota square plus B cube 1 upon 3 iota whole cube. This is equals to minus 8 plus 3 will cancel, 3 2 2 yeah, 4 iota plus 1 upon 9 1 upon 3 2 upon 3 2 upon 3 iota square plus 1 upon 3 3 yeah, 9 3 yeah, 27 iota cube. Finally this is equals to minus 8 plus 4 iota minus 2 by 3 iota square is equals to minus 1 iota square equals to minus 1. So minus 2 by 3 plus 1 by 27 iota cube, that is minus iota. Okay, so real part are this and this, imaginary part are this and this. So adding real part with that, subtracting real part from real part, 2 by 3 plus iota 4 minus 1 by 27. Okay, 4 minus 1 by 27, 8 minus 2 by 3 minus, and this is equals to minus 3, 8 jar 24 minus 2, 22 by 3. And 27, 4 jar 108, that is 107 upon 27 iota. So this is the standard form of the given complex number, that is a plus iota b. If we compare this with a plus iota b, then a is equals to minus 20 by 3. And b is equals to 107 by 27. Okay, this is also negative. Now let us take the next question. Question number 11, 12 or 13. Question number 12. Question number 12, and we have to find the multiplicative inverse. Actually, multiplicative inverse you can find. Now we will take question number 14. Question number 14. Okay. So let us take the last question of the exercise and last question of the episode of this video. Okay, question is 14. Question number 14. 3 plus iota under root 5. 3 plus iota under root 5. Multiplying 3 minus iota under root 5. Divided by under root 3 plus 2 iota. Under root 3 plus under root 2 iota. Minus under root 3 minus iota under root 2. Okay. So this is the complex number. Now we have to put this in simple complex number. Okay. So multiplying this a plus iota b, a minus iota b. We know that a plus iota b and a minus iota b is equals to a square plus b square. I have already told you how this we obtained. So this is 3 square plus under root 5 square divided by under root 3 plus under root 2 iota minus under root 3 plus under root 2 iota equals to 3 square 9 plus 5 upon under root 3 cancel 2 under root 2 iota. So 14 upon 2 under root 2 iota means 7 upon under root 2 iota. Okay, now multiplying with iota. Iota to the power 3, iota to the power 3 equals to 7 upon under root 2, iota to the power 3 upon iota to the power 4, that is all. 7 upon under root 2 into iota to the power 3 equals to minus iota. So, this is equals to minus 7 upon under root 2, iota. Minus 7 upon under root 2, iota. Now, this can be put in the form of a plus iota b. So this is equal to 0 plus minus 7 upon under root 2 iota. So a equals to 0 and b equals to minus 7 upon under root 2. After comparing this with a plus iota b, that is under root 2 upon under root 2 equals to minus 7 under root 2 upon 2. Okay. This can, minus 7 upon under root 2 can also be put in the form of minus 7 under root 2 upon 2 by multiplying under root 2 numerator and denominator. Okay, so this is the question, last question, that is question number 14 of the exercise 5.1.